just called
Yeah, I know. You stop that.
Stop that. It's Cleveland Guardians, Grandma.
That's right, Marty Gerrell. They're the Guardians now.
The Cleveland baseball team changing their name from the Cleveland Indians to the Cleveland Guardians is an issue that has sparked a lot of controversy and a lot of different opinions from various perspectives that we're going to be discussing today in the documentary. The first perspective that we heard from was Paul Dolan, the owner of the Cleveland Guardians.
In searching for a new brand, we sought a name that strongly reflects the pride, resiliency, and loyalty of Clevelanders. Guardians embodies those defining attributes while drawing upon the iconic Guardians of Traffic, proudly standing just outside Progressive Field on the Hope Memorial Bridge. It brings to life the pride Clevelanders take in our city and the way we stand for each other while defending our Cleveland baseball family.
Then we went to the Cleveland Guardians game to get some of the fans' perspectives.
So my take on this is if it's like bothersome to people, I like baseball. I just call it all baseball. I would just rather it not hurt feelings anyway. So I know that everyone's like, oh, they'll always be my Indians, they'll always be my Indians. Well, you know what, it is hurtful. And how hard is it really to then call them the Guardians? Okay, it is what it is. Let's just play baseball and let's just, you know, have fun with it. So I'm not bothered by it one bit.
Not happy. We refuse to accept the Guardians. He should have stood up for the team.
I personally, it don't really affect me. I didn't really come to the games before. It's only my second game coming to. I'm not a baseball fan, but let's go Guardians.
Honestly, I don't really care. I like Indian sound a little bit better, but, you know, that's about it.
Yeah. Here's what some people on social media had to say about it. We decided to interview the National Congress of American Indians. This organization was founded in 1944, and since then they have worked towards preserving the culture of American Indians and making sure America's view of them is accurate. A summary of their responses to our questions were that they primarily stick to the principle of stereotypical and dehumanizing sports mascots, monikers, and symbols cause well-documented harms to Native people, particularly youth, and they have no place in American society. They also mentioned that while they've made headway on name changing, there is still much to get done, and they will continue to inform the public on the values of Native people and what is offensive and what is not. Next, we decided it'd be useful to hear from our head baseball coach at Jackson High School, Bill Gamble.
I understand the why, you know, that things had to, that the name Indians had to go away, especially being in with the derogatory connotations that come around it. But on a personal level, and being a baseball person, and being a growing up as a Cleveland fan, I think there's ways you could have done it without actually changing the name. Staying with more Cleveland, staying with the name, and taking the name off the jersey could have been a way of doing it. Not, I know they went away from Chief Wahoo, who was again another derogatory logo, which makes total sense, and I think everybody got that. But you could have used, again, stayed with the Curse of Eye. A lot of marketing schemes you could have went with. And I think the thing that frustrates probably most of the diehards is that current logo that they have look like they made it on clip art. Mm-hmm. You know, so it's a bad logo coming back with it. And we know the why, because of the bridge and all of that. There's some historical relevance to it, which I think is really cool about it. But again, I think to the traditionalists, I think that's where, where I think most are a little bit frustrated with it.
Mm-hmm. Finally, from our very own Mr. Gillette.
All right. So I grew up in Lakewood, Ohio, right outside of Cleveland. I was a huge Indians fan growing up. And still am today. But as far as the team name change goes, I guess I don't really have a huge problem with it. And here's why. Because in the late 90s, I was out of college. My friend John had gotten a job as a Border Patrol agent in Arizona. So John and some buddies and I rented a U-Haul. We moved him down there. And so we were in the Painted Desert on a Navajo reservation in Arizona. And I, as I did just about every day in those days, was wearing my old school Chief Wahoo hat, and not the red Chief Wahoo that we're all familiar with, but the 1920s and 30s Chief Wahoo, which is atrocious. But I wasn't thinking anything of it. And it was my turn to buy the hotel, and we happened to be at this Navajo hotel in the Painted Desert, and I couldn't figure out why the guy behind the counter was being so mean to me and standoffish and kind of looking above my head, because it didn't even connect. Anyhow, I went back to the car after getting a room. God, this guy was a jerk, blah, blah, blah. Saw my reflection in the window of the car. Because I was basically wearing this gross caricature, which was a cool hat, I felt, back then. But he was sort of, it was face-to-face confronting this guy with a cartoon image of his race of people. And I guess in that moment I realized, well, yeah, I guess I see where they're coming from. So anyhow, that's, for what it's worth, that's all.
Here's a clip of the Jackson Youth Baseball team getting interviewed on what their favorite baseball team is. While some say the Guardians, some stick with the Indians. Notice the difference in the reactions of the audience.
My position is catcher. My favorite team is the Guardians.
Hi, I'm Michael Battle. And I'll play catcher, and my favorite team is the Indians.
Hey, let's give it up for the Jackson Polar Bears gold team. Today's deep out of North Canton, and Drew T. Ethan. We'll see.
It's Iggy Iggs. They got one more problem with you, girl. Hey!